enhanced transparency framework and global stocktaking. So this is an important aspect of Paris Agreement. And in this, I'll just draw. A timeline so that we understand this enhanced transparency framework better. Okay, so let's say this is 2015 Paris Agreement. Let me draw here 2025. Okay, so I'm going to do this. Then I'm going to put three other years. So this is 2018. This is 2023. Now, what is 2015? 2015 is Paris Agreement itself. Paris Agreement itself. Okay. So in Paris Agreement, every country, what does country say? That we will have a plan. So they had a plan in Paris Agreement. Then what does the country has to do? The plan has to be revised once every 5 years. And no backsliding allowed. This is what I told you. The next target should be tougher than the earlier target. So in 2020, for the countries, will be the first revised target. You can name it whichever way you want. I'm calling it as the first revised target, or you can just call it as the second target. And 2025, it will be the second revised target. So on and so forth. Clear? So far, so clear? 15, 20, 25, it goes every 5 years. Then the country has made a promise of reducing CO2 emissions by X tons, let's say. How will UNFCCC know that they are doing it? They will know the country reports it. So there is a mechanism for stock taking. This is a mechanism for stock taking. What it means is, let's say 2023. So India has revised its target, let's say in 2020. So what India will say is, by 2025, we will reduce our CO2 emission, let's say by 10 gigatons. I'm just giving a random example. By 2025, we'll reduce our CO2 emission by 10 gigatons. So the UNFCCC will not wait for 2025. What if India has not made any improvement at all? In 2023, it will call all countries, India, all countries, and find do something like a midterm review, because three out of 5 years has gone. This is 2020. 23 is the review. 25 is the time when they are actually supposed to achieve. So there is a review. So there is a good pressure if you look at it. If you look at it, this is one sequence and this is another sequence, right? If I call this as one and this I call it as a two. The chronology of one is assuring or promising emission reduction target. The chronology shown by two is what? It is a monitoring mechanism. Yeah, I hope that is clear. So that is what they are calling it as enhanced transparency framework and global stocktaking. This is somewhat the core of Paris Agreement, because anyway, your nationally determined contribution is your choice. Whatever you are deciding to do, at least do it honestly.